Jefferson Multimedia, how you doing tonight? I want to show you a couple tricks on how to film and edit on your phone. We're in the middle of a big computer switchover where we're moving from Apple computers to PCs. So it's a big system change. And our school laptops are not good at editing video, but we can do things on our phones that we've never been able to do before. So I've had a few students ask me, do I need to film on my phone for this class? And the answer is no. Do I need to have a social media account for this class? The answer for that is no too. But many of us can film and edit videos on our phone that are quality content that we can stick on our Jeff Media YouTube account and show them off. So here's how to do it.
Let's learn how to edit on our phones today. I want to use an app called InShot. It's a favorite of mine. First, start by looking for the app on wherever you get your apps. I'm an iPhone guy, so I go to App Store. If you're an Android person, go to wherever you get your apps that you like the best. And I'm going to click on the InShot icon once I've downloaded and installed it. Right. And where does that take us? Takes me to the main screen. I want to create something new. I wonder what it could be. How about a video? Now, I want to make a new draft. So I've scrolled down to what I want. I've just got some pictures of my apartment because I wanted to do that. So let me select the ones I want. I'm going to select each. Notice how I click them. Each one gets a check mark. What it's going to do, I can skip that one. That was my dinner the other night. Click on this one. Click on this one. Click on everything that I like. They all have a check mark. I click on the green check mark. So this is the one I want. I've gone through all of my clips. I've watched the ones that I didn't want to see, and I've clicked on them. Once that happens, if I want to delete something, see that delete button? Yeah, you hit delete, and it goes away. But this is the shot I want to start with. I want to do a fade in from black at the beginning. So when you want to add a clip, see the plus sign? Click it. Click on blank. After you've added that black clip at the beginning, let's make it a little shorter because right now, how long is it? 3 seconds. If I click on it, it'll show me how long it is. Notice when I clicked on it, you see two white like rectangles. One is on the left-hand side. That's the endpoint. That's where a video starts. The one is on the right-hand side. That's the arrow pointy looking thing. That's the out point. That's where the video ends. So I want to start from black, and then I just want to fade into my first picture. So my introduction is a little bit more dramatic. Yeah. So I'm going to click anywhere in the picture except where I've clicked now. So click off on like the gray part. And then it becomes this little thing with a slash mark in it. If I press on that, I want to do the most basic transition, which is the cross dissolve. It's the first one. Woo! It looks like that. You can make it longer or shorter by moving this little guy. But in this case, I think 1.0 seconds is just fine. How's it look? Just like that. Press the check mark. And then I have 3 seconds of black. And then it fades in. 3 seconds is too long though. How do I make something short again? I press on the clip, which in this case is this checkered thing, and I can take the endpoint, or I can put my finger on the rectangle on the left-hand side and I can slide it over. Notice how the time gets shorter. Like 1.5 seconds should be fine, right? Let's find out. I'm gonna click off by clicking on any part that's not the white rectangle right now. So I'll click up next to the black screen and play it. Swoosh. Now the shot starts. I want it to stop right before I get to my bunny pen because I'm showing a big swash of my living room, but I want to save the bunny, and I have a bunny for later in the video. She's in the green and white pen that's right there. So do I want to stop it? Maybe a little bit before she comes on the screen? Yeah. Notice the picture's moving back and forth. This is just me literally putting my thumb on the timeline and wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
My money don't jiggle, jiggle, it folds. I like to see you wiggle, wiggle, for sure. It makes me wanna dribble, dribble. You know, riding in my Fiat, you really have to see it.
So to select any video, you just press it with your pointy finger, and I'm gonna take the out point, which is that rectangle on the right-hand side. I'm gonna press it. I'm gonna move it over to right there. Yeah, that looks good. Next, what do we have? Oh, we've got my cool little lamp thing. So let's put a cross dissolve in there too. I'm gonna click on the little white square between the shots. This takes me to my transitions. I'm so basic. This is the pumpkin spice of video production. That's your 1 second crossfade. How's it gonna look? It shows you. If you like it, hit your check mark. Now, this is not the most exciting shot in the world. It's just a lamp, right? I wanna make it shorter, so I'm gonna click inside of it. If it's something that doesn't move much, actually, you can look at it for about 7 seconds and you'll get the hang of it. I'm gonna click off, and then I'm gonna hit play. Swish. I think even 7 seconds is too long. Let's make it like 5. So I've clicked on the clip again, which will let me make it longer or shorter. Grab that rectangle with the arrow on the end and move it over. See how the time is shrinking? It's shrinking. Let's go to 5. What are we looking at next? Is it my dining table? Ooh, exciting. And notice I've gone with a high angle. I've got my phone on a tripod. There's not a lot of movement going on. This is just gonna be a simple like photography project and showing things from several different angles. Did you see my shadow? You see my shadow moving right there? That means I probably wanna end the shot before my shadow comes in it, because shadows are distracting. So to make anything shorter, you click on the video itself. So I'm gonna grab the rectangle on the right, which is the end point, and I'm gonna move it forward just by holding with my finger and moving it back. Same thing, let's go like 6 seconds. And then let's go ahead and make the transition between that and the cool decorations in the hallway into the crossfade. Click on the check mark and let's watch the whole thing. Fade in from black. Now this is a slow pan across the room. Remember, a pan is when you move the camera from side to side. A tilt is when you swivel it up or down. Crossfade to the lamp. And then click on the transition and add that crossfade. Let's see if the lamp's jiggly. Nope. Crossfade to the table. About 5 seconds of that is okay. Then we crossfade to the stuff in the hallway. Now you see what I'm doing with each of these is I'm trimming them to the appropriate length, because anytime you make a movie, especially if it's a photography project like this where the thing doesn't move, tape it for way longer than you think you're gonna need. Then, when you're ready to get that transition, when you want to go to the next one, remember to click any video in your timeline and you'll get the end point at the beginning, the out point at the back, and I'm just going to scooch it back. So you get the point. Add your videos and then trim them to the length you want. When they're the right length, if you press in the black part up next to the screen where the video plays, you'll deselect and then look for that little white square. You can press it, set it for the first transition, basic with the slash mark, and then right after that, that first circle is your cross dissolve, and you can change the length of it by moving this slider here. So I hit the check mark. We have learned how to load things in. We have learned how to make them shorter and make them longer, and we have learned how to do transitions. Now let's talk about putting your video clips in a different order. If you wanna move them around, pick any clip, press on it with your pointy finger and hold. What happens is, look at the bottom, we have a bunch of different shots we can use. Say I wanted to use this shot because I have a cool lamp with a stained glass bulb in it, and move it to another place. I just click it, hold it with my finger, and I move it, and things shift, and everything that you want to look at, you can move around. So that's how to load your videos in, that's how to trim each of them, how to do transitions, and how to move each one. Tomorrow, we'll talk about some other cool stuff and how to use InShot. That's all I got. Thanks. Bye-bye.